2015 saw the first three bell test experiments that claimed to contain no loopholes. Surely spooky action at a distance must really be happening. One approach that a skeptic could use to try to guess why these experiments are violating Bell inequalities would be to compare the loophole-free experiments and search for common factors. The fact that all the experiments use hardware random number generators, either partly or exclusively, is highly suspicious. There's no real excuse for using hardware random number generators. If the universe could mysteriously predict the sequence of an algorithm, then surely the universe could equally predict the sequence produced by a hardware random number generator. So why would anyone choose these devices when their reliance on physical materials means that they are prone to bias? Physical properties of materials can change due to things like temperature change, application of an electrical field, and so on. It is true that a bias in the random number generators alone would not be able to violate a Bell inequality. But if the production of the photon pairs also has some bias, then the combined effect could cause a violation. Let's demonstrate this with a simple made-up example. This is the inequality we want to violate. The four terms are probabilities, where plus means detected and zero means not detected. So the third term, P0 plus of A2B1, means the probability of not detected at side A, but detected at side B, for angle settings A2B1. Now let's completely make up some cause for bias in the random number generators, such as an alternating current from the power supply. The bias might result in the setting combination A2B2 occurring almost exclusively if a random number is requested at the peaks and troughs of the alternating current. There might be a similar very strong bias in favour of other combinations at other parts of the alternating current, and as a result, there might not be any overall noticeable bias. But if there is also bias in the rate at which photon pairs are produced, then, as shown here, we could end up with a disproportionately low count for one of the settings combinations. This would result in this term in the inequality being disproportionately small, which could result in an apparent violation. Given this type of problem, you might think it's very important to avoid the use of hardware random number generators. And you would be correct. As it is so important to avoid these, how many loophole-free experiments do avoid them? None of them. This might be a bit concerning, but surely we can't use it to match the results of an actual experiment, can we? Well, if we include another very simple effect, then yes, we can. Our results will go into this table. First, we'll start with four zones, one for each of the settings combinations. And as before, we'll have a low rate of photon production for the A2B2 setting. So the photon pair production will be very low for this 2-2 zone. Then we can invent some probabilities for the detection of a photon. And we can easily generate some figures that we can relate to the inequality. The count relating to the first term will be this one. For the second term will be this one. Third term, this one. And finally, the fourth term will relate to this one. These are very close to the actual figures in one of the experiments, except that these four values were far, far bigger in the real experiment. So how can we duplicate that? Well, a simple way is to not assume that a pair of photons is always produced. So we can simply say that we got these singles on the Alice side, and these singles on the Bob side. Note that I have assumed 100% detection so that we can simply add these figures to the corresponding figures highlighted in yellow and get the desired results. Normally, detection would be less than 100%, and so these singles counts would need to be a bit higher to get the same results. So the apparent violation only occurs when you combine it with the other real-world deviating property, that is, the rate at which photon pairs are created. You could say we are combining aberrating properties, where aberrating means deviating from the standard state. This is called the combined real-world aberrating properties loophole, or the CRAP loophole for short. And if you don't get rid of the bias over time, then you risk being susceptible to this loophole. This video is brought to you by extremefinitism.com.